Welcome back, everybody, to T Square Technical Talk YouTube channel. This episode number 3, The Project, which will be narrated by Mohammed Nagy. Today, we will be showing to you a new Python project. This video comes with 3 different subtitles upon your preferences: English, Spanish, and Arabic. Before we go on, we would really appreciate if you all gave us a like, subscribe, and turn on the notification bell so can get notified all our videos. Throughout the upcoming videos in this Python course, we will explain several basic concepts in Python, like libraries, which are ready-made code that you can use instantly, while custom functions are functions that can be made by anyone, even you. Decision making, that you can think of it as real-life decision. For example, your mom will allow you to play video games for 30 minutes only if you complete or finish your homework. Loops are a portion of codes that can repeat itself continuously for a certain number of times, or until you command it to no longer work. Also, we will learn about data and information that can be imported from outside our code, such as importing data Excel sheet. And lastly, errors are mistakes caught inside the code. Errors could be spelling mistakes, for example, and we will explain to you the kinds of errors that may occur in your code and teach you how to find an error in your code and how to fix it. Let's see the project story. One day, my dad came home and called, "Mohammed, where are you?" "Daddy," Mohammed replied. "Look, Mohammed, I got for us a big box of fruit that I want you to distribute amongst the family," my dad requested. Mohammed started to think what to do with that box with 3 different types of fruits: orange, apple, and pineapple. Mohammed thought about getting help from his robot. He set all the fruits on a table for the robot. Then he bought 3 containers, and the robot started to classify the fruits one by one and put them inside a different box based on their kinds. And lastly, the robot began making the mathematical calculations on the total fruits amount to give them amongst the family members. Let's see how our codes will be built for this project. First, we need to collect project data, which were the fruits arrangement in the dad box. Secondly, to classify each fruit. Third, putting each type of fruit inside a separate box that implies counting them. And lastly, to give them to the family members based on the age and other criteria.
Now, you guys, and welcome back to T Square Technical Talk YouTube channel. Episode number 3, The Project. So what should we do now? Let's create the framework for our coding, which is the base for all our code in this program will reside. Let's start by going to create a new notebook in Google Colab. If you don't know how to log in or use Google Colab, please watch the video in the link card in the top right corner. Now let's create our new notebook. This is the file name. The file name always ends with a .ipynb. This stands for iPython Notebook. We will name this file the fruit box. Once you press enter, this notebook will automatically be saved in your Google Drive. Now let's create our title. Let's add a text cell up here. This is the title that we have chosen inside a text cell. And we use the level 1 heading by putting 1 hash only. This is called a markdown. Markdown is not a code to be executed. Markdown is just a language frequently used by developers to write documentations in Python projects. And what does it mean? It is how we will be writing descriptions, titles, tags in our code. Let me give you an example of using Markdown while creating different levels of headings. One hash is the level one heading, which is the largest size. In the right half, Google Colab shows you the appearance of your script from your text cell. Using two hashes will cause a level two heading, which is smaller than the level one. This is the appearance, and so on, level three. Level 4, and lastly, level 5. These are the appearance of all 5 headings. Headings are not only used for controlling the size of the text. It is also used for organizing and navigating your code throughout the table of contents that I will show you by the end of the video. Let's delete this cell. Let's add the logo for our project. Here I am using the logo for our YouTube channel. Let's create a new text cell. Let's paste our picture data. If you don't know how to do this, please go back to our second video, Zombies Have Returned, in the link card at the top right corner of the screen. Now, let's add our description. Let's create a new text cell. Let's put two hashes. Here is our description. Here, as you can see, I used two hashes to create a second level heading. This is the description of our project. Here is our description, and it shows our explanation of what we will do in this project. Also, there are inputs, outputs, and external libraries, which I will be talking about in the upcoming videos. And lastly, some notes about the owner of that code. In the first half of this video, Muhammad explained to you the project story, and it was mainly divided in 4 sections. And the first section was collecting your data. We used two hashes in this one because it is also another subtitle. I will leave this code cell for our upcoming codes for this section. The second section, in the second section, it was classify each item. We will also still be using two hashes as this is also another subtitle. As our previous code cell, we will be leaving this code for our future codes for that section. The third section was counting your total numbers, and our last section was distributing your calculations. Finally, we have created our 4 main sections and reserved one code cell for each one of those sections, and we can add more if we need more. Lastly, we will be showing you how to navigate and organize using your table of contents. All the headers that you have created throughout the entire notebook shall appear in the table of contents. It is created automatically once you finish writing your header in your text cell. As you can see, if you click on any of the code cells, the yellow line will appear next to the header that you are currently in. And also, you can use it to navigate quickly throughout your entire notebook. With that, I have concluded my video for this episode. Please remember to leave a like, subscribe to our YouTube channel, and share this video with your friends. Thank you, and see you in the next video.